وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One of the lessons to learn in the verses of the Quran that talks about Hajj is the lessons of guidance. Al-Hidayah is only in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides whom whoever He wills, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for a person to know what is right and what is wrong, and for the person to be guided to do what is right and to avoid what is evil, is the greatest ni'mah and bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded the believers in the verses of Hajj, for those who went for Hajj, reminding them of this fact, as He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتٍ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ عِنْدَ الْمَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ وَاذْكُرُوهُ كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding the believers that after you leave the place of Arafat, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala عِنْدَ الْمَشْعَرِ الْحَرَامِ, in the place of Al-Muzdalifah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding the believers to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كَمَا هَدَاكُمْ, same way that He had guided you. وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ لَمِنَ الضَّالِينَ, in which you were before He guided you, you were astray, you were in deviation, clear astray, total darkness, without the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this verse and other verses also, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also about the Hajj and Kaaba, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِعَ لِلنَّاسِ لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the first place of worship, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Mecca, blessed and guidance to all mankind and all that exists. So the Kaaba, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's been built for what purpose? For guidance of all mankind to come to that place to worship none but the Creator of the heavens and the earth. And this is the guidance to the truth, to the tawheed, to the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many human beings on the face of earth are away from guidance? They are led astray. They worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are forgetful about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the real misery on the face of earth. When a person Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for him or for her, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them, when they breathe the air that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, when they eat the provisions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided, but they do not know the purpose of their life. They do not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. The shayateen, the devils, had beautified to them the worship of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They claim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had a son, or whatever deviations that they are in, or even for those who claim to be Muslims, when they live a life of sin and forgetfulness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the person would realize that the real benefit and the real guidance and the real gift is to be guided to the truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the believers that it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose some people to be guided and others not to be guided? It's all by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. And that by itself would bring the joy in the hearts of those who are making Hajj, in the hearts of those who are believers, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them to be among those who are guided, those who would see what is right, right, and what is wrong, is wrong. And to realize that without the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the human being is in astray, is in deviation, and deviation would lead the person to the hellfire. To see the importance of being guided, we get to recite that in every time we stand in the salah. When a person would say, اِهْدِنَا الصَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ, this is the most important dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to ask in the most virtuous surah. Surah Al-Fatiha is the most virtuous surah, and in it the most virtuous dua, and that is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance. We are ordered in Surah Al-Fatiha, after praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to ask for provisions of this life, not to ask even to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we were asked to be guided to the straight path. Because if a person is guided to the straight path, that comes after that the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a person would fulfill this, would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely to be guided, this is the best guidance for the person to be in such a state, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be guided to the straight path. Ihdina salat al-mustaqim. And then we know that the salat al-mustaqim, the straight path, is the path of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed His ni'mah on them, His bounty on them, the prophets, the trust, the truthful ones, the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the righteous ones and the martyrs. These are the ones that the Muslims seek to be among them, to imitate the ways of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even more, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he mentioned that the need of the human being to be guided is more than the need of being victorious or to have establishment on the face of earth. Why? Because if a person is guided, he will be established. He will be victorious. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِن تَنْصُرُوا اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. If you make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala victorious by making the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala victorious, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you victorious. So people are in need of guidance first and foremost. And this is something that we get to learn in the verses of the Quran that talks about Hajj, that the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Mecca is being built for that purpose. The Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are the words of guidance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran for the guidance of all mankind, for them to read and to be guided to follow the truth. And also in the verses of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us how to be guided. The only way to be guided is to follow the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is also in these verses of Al-Hajj. فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَمَا عَلَّمَكُمْ. That make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He taught you, not according to your own desires. So you do not even worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to your own desire. We need the guidance to be guided to the religion of Islam, to submit ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need the guidance to be steadfast on the salat al-mustaqim. We need guidance in guidance. With every word we say, with every actions we do, we need the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be according to the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How many Muslims today, they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on their own desires or what their forefathers have been teaching them. Whether it's the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or not, they would just worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on that. This is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, He wants us to worship Him according to the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. So we need the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be able to worship Him according to the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. We need the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to speak the truth. We need the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to establish the 5 daily prayers, to do the night prayer, to do the dhikr, to be kind to one another. For all of our affairs, we need the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why there are two forms of guidance. There is the guidance of that the matters are being explained to us, al-bayan wal-irshad, that is mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, that we need to have this knowledge of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. But knowledge is one thing, which is a form of guidance. The other form of guidance is to be guided to apply what we know, to apply what we have learned, to apply what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, that we know for sure that He wants from us to be patient, that He wants from us to worship Him alone, that He wants from us to be obedient to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So knowing, it would not take the person to the Jannah unless the person would practice what he or she knows. And that's why it's two forms of guidance. And we get to learn that in the rituals of Hajj, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us in the verses of Hajj to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that He guided us, in which before we are in clear astray and deviation. We were guided to embrace the religion of Islam, but there are still some forms of deviation still for those who embrace Islam, unless they are guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do every single action and every single word and every single state that we are in to be according to the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Knowing this would make the Muslim realize that we have a job on the face of earth, and not to be neglectful. It's not just enough to say I'm a Muslim and I just rely on that fact, and using that and the good intentions for the person to be good. It doesn't work this way. We need to have the good intentions, the sincere intentions, and we need to have the guidance, the way of the Prophet ﷺ, in all of our affairs. So we need to learn our religion. We need to get to know. The same thing for Hajj. With good intentions by itself would serve the person and make him among those who are saved and among those who would have their Hajj accepted. It doesn't work this way unless they make the Hajj, the rituals of Hajj, according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ. The same thing with the Salah, the same thing with Dhikr, the same thing with fasting, the same thing with everything in our life. We need to seek that part of knowledge of how to perform things according to the way of the Prophet ﷺ. But knowing needs another form of power, and that is to be guided to act according to what we know, the way of the Prophet ﷺ. So that's why guidance is the most valuable thing that a Muslim would seek in this life, is to be guided on the straight path, as we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that in Surah Al-Fatiha, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded the believers in the verses of Al-Hajj in Surah Al-Baqarah and others, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the verse that the establishment or the build of Al-Kaaba is for the purpose of guidance to Al-Alameen, the guidance to all men and women, the human beings and jinn and all that exists. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Ibrahim alayhi salam build the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Kaaba, so that people would worship none but the creator of the heavens and the earth. They do not go there to worship human beings or to worship their own desires or just for the purpose of gatherings, but they would go there to invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember the creator of the heavens and the earth, and to worship him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the purpose of life. So guidance is such an important thing. And we learn that in the verses of the Qur'an. And we need to have this attitude with us throughout our whole entire life, because we need it with every word we say, every action we do, and every state that we are in. We need to have the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following the Qur'an and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ